गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, दिस इज दीपिका लूना, योर आई टी टीचर. सो आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल एंड कम्प्लीटिंग ऑल योर वर्क रेगुलरली एंड चेकिंग ऑल द ट्यूटोरियल्स ऑल्सो. सी सून योर ऑनलाइन क्विज इज अबाउट टू स्टार्ट. सिलेबस इज ऑलरेडी शेयर्ड विद यू थ्रू स्कूल फेसबुक पेज. सो आई होप we have started preparation. So let's start with today's tutorial. In the last tutorial we discussed about text data type, that is char, varchar, long varchar and varchar ignore case. So text data type is used to store text and number value or the combination of both. So this is the data type which is mostly used for the short entries text and the long entries text or text also. So char and varchar, we have already discussed about it. So what is the difference between char and varchar? The most important difference is the that char is a fixed length variable and fixed length data type, and varchar is a variable length data type. In case of char, there is wastage of memory space, but in case of varchar, there is no wastage of memory space because whatever length you are specifying, as name is given Rohit, so if we specify length 5, so it will occupy only the 5 bytes for this. So if we have specified the length 10, so it will occupy the 5 bytes in the memory, and the rest of the 5 spaces will not be 5 bytes will not be padded with white spaces, whereas in case of char, if you are using a length 10, then whether it is being used or not, still it will be it will be occupied. And suppose if a length specified is 10 and name you have mentioned like Rohit, Arun, which is occupying only 3 or 4 bytes, then the rest of the bytes will be occupied with the, or we can say the padded with the white spaces. So then MAMO data type is used for the long entries. It is also known as long text data type. And ignore case data type, where it will ignore whatever you will type, it will be automatically changing it into the capital case or capital letter. So that is what we discussed in the last tutorial. Today's lesson objective is to know more about data types. As you know, in the last tutorial we discussed about text data type. In this tutorial we will learn about Boolean data type, numeric data type, real, float and double data type, decimal data type, binary data type, and then date and time data type. At the end of the discussion of the data types, you have a practice question in which you will mention the data type for different fields available in that question. Under numeric, the first data type we have, that is Boolean. Boolean data type, it is a data type that has one of two possible values, which can be denoted either by yes or no, or on or off. One will be for on and zero will be for off, or true or false. If we talk about the default value for the Boolean data type, that will be false. If you take an example, like the comparisons 3 is less than 5. So this is a Boolean expression. The comparison 3 is less than 5 will always give the result true, because 3 is always less than 5. If we have a look on these two tables, one is purchase, another is student. In purchase table, we have fields purchase time, sales ID, customer ID, currency amount paid device and has discount. Now this has discount table field in the purchase table is having only two values, either true or either false. Similarly, for the student table with the field name student ID, first name, last name and financial aid. Now this financial aid field is having only two values, that is yes or no. So if we have to give such data and if we have to make such data entries in our table field, then we prefer to use Boolean data type. Next we have big integer, integer, small integer and tiny integer. So first of all, what is integer? Integer is actually a whole number that can have a positive, negative or a zero value. It cannot be a fraction, nor can have decimal places. If I say 23, then this is an integer number. But if I say 23.30, then it is not an integer number. Now it will be a decimal number. So any whole number can be called as an integer number. Big integer, that is BIGINT, big integer is used to store a very large integer value. Whereas int, that is integer, it is used to store a large integer value, but that is smaller than which can be stored by a big integer data type. Small integer, accordingly, it will be able to store an integer number but smaller than the integer data type. Tiny integer, it is clearly shows that 0 to 255. If we have to store a very small integer number, then we prefer to use tiny integer data type. Whenever we are adding some records in the tables in the database, it is not always necessary that we have to store a value as an integer, like without fractions or without decimals. It might be possible somehow we need to store some values which can include a decimal number also. So if we talk about salary of a person, which can be an integer value also, which can be a decimal value also. So if we have to store such values, then the data types which we can use, that is real, float and double. Each of these data types basically store decimal values, but there is a difference in the precision. Now what is this precision? That is the number of digits after the decimal point of a number, that how many digits you can place after the decimal. In some cases numbers are infinite and in some cases they are so long that they even have no meaning. So precision means that how many numbers you want to display or you want to see after the decimal. If you talk about real data type, so real data type has 7 digits precision. It means after the decimal you can see, you can use 7 digits. If I take this number, now this is a number which can be used for real data type, because we count 3, 4, 5, 7, 3, there are 7 digits after the decimal. Next is float and double. Similar to real, float data type is also used to store the decimal values. But here is the difference, and difference is of the precision. Like float can store store the value with more precision as compared to the real number. Moreover, it can store the large number as compared to the real number. So if we talk about float, then float data type has 15 digits precision. It means with accuracy, it can display 15 digits after the decimal. So if I show a number, then this is a number with 15 digits after the decimal. Now let's talk about the double. Double data type is also similar to the float data type, but it is used for the large numbers and it provides you more precision. Moreover, double precision as compared to the float data type. Decimal data type is used to store exact numeric values in the database. Decimal data type is often used for the columns that preserve exact precision. Means, for example, if we have to set it for some money data in accounting system. If we have to use decimal data type in coding, then this will be the syntax: column name, decimal, then bracket start P, comma D. P is the precision that represents the number of significant digits, as I have already told you. D is the scale that represents the number of digits after the decimal point. So P will be the total number of digits, and D will be the number of digits after the decimal. So decimal PD means that the column can store up to P digits with D decimals. Each of these data types basically store decimal values, but there is a difference in the precision. Now, what is this precision? That is the number of digits after the decimal point of a number, that how many digits you can place after the decimal. Next is binary data type. Binary data type represents a small fixed length binary value, whereas where binary, that is variable binary, represents a small variable length binary value. This is fixed and variable concept is similar to that we have discussed about char and varchar. Binary stores value in fixed lengths and values are padded with the white spaces, whereas variable binary, that is where binary, stores values in variable lengths and values are not padded with any white spaces. Now next is long where binary. It represents a large variable length binary value. And if we say, then these data types are used for storing data in binary formats. And binary data types in a database can be used for storing photos, music files, etc. Next is date and time data type. These date time data types are used for describing date and time values for the field used in the table of a database. Date time data types in a database can be used for storing information, for example, date of birth, date of admission, date of registration, date of product sale, etc. You can use different formats for the date and time. For example, if you say date, month and year, this is the one format, DDMMYY. Or you can choose the format month, date, year. Similarly for the time also, you can choose the format. Now, date will store month, day and year information, whereas time will store hour, minute and second information. Now next is timestamp. Timestamp is used when you want to store date and time both the information in one field. Then it will store the date also as well as the time also. Here you have some of the fields shown on this screen. Now you have to choose the correct data type for each field. So today we learned about different data types, in which we learned about numeric data type, and under the numeric data type we learned about integer, big integer, small integer and tiny integer. We also discussed about decimal data type. Then we discussed about binary data type, in which we discussed about long where binary, binary where binary. Further, we discussed about date and time data type, where we have date, time and timestamp data type. Further, we discussed about Boolean data type, which can only have two values, that can be yes or no, true or false, or on or off. So the question which I gave you through this video, try to say the data types. And in case you face any difficulty, just give me a call or send me a message. Thank you. Have a nice day.